sky high while I'm rocking Air Forces. She just wanna ride, shorty bad and gorgeous. She was rocking stripes, said it's alright. Then I cut her off, shorty stepped on my off-whites. Okay, now wait, wait, wait. Gotta get the bag and racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'ma say. Gotta new press those in the J's in a way. Gotta new place, watch where they don't take time. I pull up on a hop if it's talking too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit it.
We are about 15 miles south of downtown Buffalo at Bill Stadium in Orchard Park. A few moments ago, to the delight of this Buffalo crowd, it was the Bills racing out of the tunnel as they get set to match up with the Los Angeles Rams. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. This will make it into the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. First carry now for the Memphis man, Darrell Henderson. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards.
A gain of 26 yards.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle. Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ended up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Eight yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Out of the gun, gone. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
First down.
On first and 10, gone. Now they go screen, it's complete. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. On the handoff, it's Akers. And he'll slice his way down to the 30 with a pickup of 7.
Akers, the ball carrier.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
Throwing on third. Gone. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Sam Sloman for the Rams field goal. A 47.
And his kick here is good. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was open for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
At their own 25-yard line.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Opening carry of the game here for Rex Burkhead. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
Kaiser on the tackle.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26.
At the 26-yard line.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. And this one caught by Beasley.
Allen.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher if guys trying to get to the football.
He's got Smith here. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Terry with his first carry of the game. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. A'shaun Robinson there on the stop.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5 at the 42-yard line.
2nd and 5 now. Allen, and he finds Beasley complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say they're spotted right at midfield at the 50.
1st and 10.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
A give to Burkhead on 1st down. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. Complete. Smith has it. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 28. 19 yards the pickup there. Move the chains. They'll run on 1st down with Singletary. Eventually wrangled down before reaching the 20, but a strong run. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
A 6-yard pickup.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
From the 22, Allen into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. That's now a 2nd interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Tremaine Edmonds, the Bills' leading tackler in 2019, in on the stop. Off play action to Akers. Here's Goff. Flush to his right. That's going to be caught by Josh Reynolds. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. It's a 1st down on a gain of 10. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. Fake the give. Now Goff. And he's got the hook up here. It's Woods. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. So 1st and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 44-yard line. Let's go. from the gun to give to Henderson. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
On second down, it's Henderson, able to push forward for about 4 down to the 37.
Again, the ball carrier.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Goff on third down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. And he will bring this all the way back out to midfield. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week. 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. If that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
14 yards, and the Bills will get a new set of downs.
36-yard line.
Now on first down, steps away to his left, and he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Going to give this one to Singletary. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10.
It's 3rd and 10.
Stop short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
For the Bills' field goal, a 45-yard attempt.
And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And the Bills are going to tie the game at 3. So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. 2 of them give you points, either an extra point or in this case, a field goal.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Rams take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try to take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
He's going to air it out deep for Woods. A The fight for the football, and it's intercepted. The all-pro corner, Tre'Davious White, picks it off. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
From the gun, Allen. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
It's a gain of eight, and it'll wind up moving the chains.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
On the give, this is Singletary. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41.
The ball carrier.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Allen's throw is complete. It's a gain of six on the play, and they'll be faced with a third and inches. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down.
I know a lot of times we like to put players in certain boxes. He does this and he does that. But this guy, he can do a little bit of everything. He's not just a lead blocker or a guy who protects the passer. Handing the ball, he might want to get out of the way.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
The 26-yard line.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
They'll run on first down. Singletary down to the 25. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
2 yards on the
carry. Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. They get seven there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. To throw, it's Allen. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 15. He's at the 50. The 30. The 20. 10. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown.
Come on, let's go. Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks. Tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way things have gone, they need to try to make something happen offensively.
But maybe they should. Maybe they should sit on it here because of what you just said. They haven't made anything happen offensively. Getting ready to go into the half, give them a chance to take a deep breath, exhale a little bit, and start over. I don't know if this is the time to push it myself.
Yeah, right now, under 100 yards of total offense. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. And Diggs has it. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
That's good.
11 yards there. First down.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Again, they'll throw with Allen. And Beasley with it over the middle. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making them sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. A final shot before half for Allen. And that is intercepted by the Pro Bowler, Jalen Ramsey. And he will be brought down. His time is now run out on this first half of action. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. The Bills trail here, but they will get the football first as we are back underway on EA Sports. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
From the 31, Allen. He hits Beasley right side. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. Out of the shotgun, a give to Burkhead. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
A gain of 2.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Stop. From the 40 now on second down, Allen. And his throw's going to be incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown. And that'll make it third down.
Well, coming into this one, we expected that this offense would have trouble with this defense, and that's exactly the way that this game has gone. Pressure in his face, coverage downfield has been tight. That led to another incompletion. This defense, they're exactly who we thought they were coming into this one.
It's complete to Diggs. And he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down. The Bills send the punter out as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
And he's only able to work this from the 8 to the 10 for a pickup of 2. That catch good for only a couple. So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Out of the gun, they give to Henderson. And he takes this across the 15 to the 17. The LA
ball carrier. I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Fake the handoff. Now Goff. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Corner blitz by Josh Norman works like a charm. 6 yards. So they come out of the locker room trailing, but plays like that, they won't be trailing much longer. Defense really starting out well this second half.
Yeah, they knew they had to jumpstart things a little bit. They really struggled in the first half trying to slow them down. But now they had a plan, made that adjustment that we always talk about, and it worked very well on that play.
Found good room to run there. Returns at 14 yards. And the Bills will take over the football with a 1st and 10. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's...
And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Devin Singletary, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game.
Sometimes running plays hit or break so fast, there's no reaction time from the secondary. So I've got to give credit to the offensive line for creating that hole so suddenly. And how decisive was he to take that cut and just go? No one downfield there to stop him.
And he'll bang that one through.
That ties the game at 10.
All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And this carries into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a 1st and 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll be out right at the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a 1st down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half, and that trend is continuing here.
A throw out wide to Woods, complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
13 yards.
I remember covering Robert Woods in college at USC, and consistent was the word that was always used about him. Maybe we should have added dependable as well. Over 1,100 yards each of the last two seasons. This guy studied to be an NFL wide receiver while in college and has carried that over to the NFL. A pro's pro, this guy plays as hard as anyone in the league.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
A tough run there for Cam Akers, the rookie out of Florida State. And while he had some experience in that while in college, remember the Rams offensive line was inconsistent last year too. They're trying to get better. But while he was in college, oftentimes he would hesitate maybe a little bit too long behind the line of scrimmage, looking for the big run. Here in the NFL, put your foot in the ground, get your shoulders down, and get what you can.
And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 33. Goff hitting Woods for a Rams first.
And the Rams.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. On the counter, it's Henderson. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
On the tackle.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Rams on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 9. A shotgun snap for Goff. And that is incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
A 49-yard attempt.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
And this one complete to Smith. 3 yards the gain there, second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
That first down completion only netted him 3. 2nd and 7. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 42. It's a first down and a gain of 10.
At the 42-yard line.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. First down,
Singletary.
They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Singletary, the ball carrier.
That was a pretty good job defensively to hold them to a two-yard run, but I've got to think this offensive line, they're asking their quarterback for a different type of a run, one that they rely on, one they have confidence in, one they feel like they can block.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
I think you got it, sir.
Bring it right here, guys. Fight 51. Mike 51.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Singletary again. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Now third down is looming. A pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there.
Brings up 3rd and 7.
The Bills on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 7. Operating from the gun. Allen finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 22-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 on that one and a Bills first down. Here's Allen on 1st and 10. Quick hitter here, it's complete. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
Complete.
That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Here's Burkhead. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
So not quite a 1st and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. They're going to run this with a tight end. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line.
Michael Barker.
It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 12 at the 13-yard line.
Handoff, it's Singletary. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Devin Singletary, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bills have retaken the lead. He's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there, but 2 TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead.
Tyler Bass to kick off for Buffalo.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the 4th quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Right off the bat, it's a 1st down to start the drive, 12 yards.
A gain of 12.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
They'll go back to Henderson on 1st down. He's got the 1st down and more past midfield. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last 2 plays. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game.
it's Rams football here as we get your reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. On first down, it's gone. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
First down, Los Angeles.
Back to throw. And Woods has it complete. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll look to run with Henderson. And he gets halfway there down to the one-yard line. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Again, it's Henderson. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Darrell Henderson, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Rams are once again going to retake the lead.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Yeah, part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
He's got Smith here. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. Just a five-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. Gonna go on fourth down. The open man is Smith. And he's gonna have the first down yardage to the 35. The Bills are gonna go ahead and use their final timeout as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. To throw, Allen, and oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted.
You know they pay me.
Troy Hill picks it, and he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown. And so much for the game-winning two-minute drive. I think that interception return there pretty much seals the deal.
And one thing to keep in mind, in this situation with the score that close, defense isn't backing off and just giving you easy throws. They're playing aggressively as well, and they end up picking that one off and sealing the deal for themselves.
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
At their own 27-yard line.
Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that...
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. John Johnson with the INT. And he will score. Touchdown, LA.
Good job, good job.
And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
The extra point up and good. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game.
Bills 17,